A very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are fine and doing your studies at your home. Okay, in today's class we will study about the number system. What are the number system in computer? Number system are the technique to represent numbers in the computer architecture. Every value that you are saving or getting into from computer memory has a defined number system. Why we need a number system? Because we are writing a program in high level language, but computer understood the language, that is machine level language. So to convert our high level language into machine language, we need a number system. And what is machine language? Machine language that computer understood is 0 and 1. So if we are getting anything in high level language, we have to convert it into machine. The computer convert it into machine level language. That's why we need a computer system. Basically, in computer architecture, there are four type of number system. That is binary number system, octal number system, decimal number system, and hexadecimal number system. What are numbers? Binary number system. A binary number system has only two digits, that are 0 and 1. Every number represents with 0 and 1 in this number. The base of binary number system is 2. Okay, I'm again repeating, the base of binary number system is 2. Okay, whenever we write any binary number, we have to denote it with 2 because it has only 2 digits. Binary number system is having only 2 digits, and these 2 digits are 0 and 1. Okay, what are octal number system? Octal number system has only 8 digits from 0 to 7. As I told you, binary number system having 0 and 1, octal number system is having 0 to 7. Every number value represent with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 in this number system. The base of octal number system is 8. And what's the base of binary number system? That is 2. Remember all these things. Okay, these are very important things in number system, because now, in octal number system has only 8 digits, that's why its base is 8. Next, decimal number system. Decimal, what are decimal number system? Decimal number system has only 10 digits. Those are 0 to 9. Every number represent with 0 to 9 in this number system. The base of decimal number system is 10 because it has only 10 digits. Okay, wait, yeah. Hexadecimal number system. A hexadecimal number system has 16 alphanumeric values from 0 to 9 and A to F. So it will work like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And after 9, it will work in the form of alphabet. Those are, and remember, these would be capital, never be small. Okay, A, B, C, D, E and F in this number system. The base number system is 16 because it has 16 alphanumeric values. Okay, so here A is considered as a 10, B is considered as 11, C is as 12, D is as 13, E is 14 and F is as 15. Now, the table of number system with base using digit represent, and I'm showing their representation. Now, how they will, with the example, how they will look like. So it's a binary number system. Wait, I'm zooming it. Yeah. Okay. it's a binary number system. Here it base is what the base of binary number system 2, and what are the digit we are using 0 and 1. This is an example of binary number system, how it will show, because as I told you, binary number system always work in 0 1 form. So it's 1 1 1 1 and 0 0 0. And here if you see, 2 is written over here, okay, that shows the number is binary and the base is 2. Fine. Now next come to octal number. Octal number, as I told you, that its base is 8. So it's written over here, and the number in octal number comes 0 to 7. If we write any number with a base of 8, that means that from here you will understand that this is an octal number, because 8 is written over here. Okay. Next is decimal. Decimal, what the base of decimal? 10. Then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These all are decimal, come under a decimal number. Fine. 240 with base or base 10. 10 is written over here. From here, we can understand that it's a decimal number. Always remember, we have to write with every number base. Okay, it's mandatory to write a from, because from there only you can understand either it is octal, decimal or a hexadecimal number. Next is your hexadecimal number with base 16. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and ABC. Sorry, 6, 7, 8, 9, ABC, D, E, F. Fine. It's written over here F0 with base of 16. That means this is your hexadecimal number. Okay, till here we study what are binary, octal, decimal, hexadecimal number. But how we will convert, if anything, any decimal number is given to you, how you will convert it in bit in the form of 10? Here we will see how we will convert the number into binary. Okay, here are some conversion, number system conversion. There are three type of conversion, main are three type: decimal number system to other base, then other base to decimal number system, other base to other base. Okay, wait, yeah, see, decimal number system to other base, what are, if we are converting from decimal number system to other base, what other base are left? 2, 8 and 16. 2 is for binary, 8 is for octal, 16 is for hexadecimal. To convert number system from decimal number system to any another base is quite easy. You have to follow just 2 steps. Divide the number. First is, remember, divide the number by the base to target base system in which you want to convert the number, binary, octal and hexadecimal. And what is second step? Write the remainder from step 1 as a least significant bit, that is LSB, to step last as most significant bit. There are two type of bits are showing over here, LSB and MSB. Okay, LSB is your least significant bit and MSB is your most significant bit. See how you will convert decimal to binary conversion. This is your number, this is your number, decimal number, okay, and this is your binary number. See how you will get from this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this number. See, here is your number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is your decimal number, okay, when you, because your base, you have to convert this decimal number to binary number. Wait. Because you are converting from decimal to binary. And what's the base of your decimal is? I'm writing in bracket. It's 10. and what the base of binary is 2. Fine. Okay. Fine. See, you are getting from decimal to binary. As first rule says that divide the number, decimal number is your decimal, by the base of target base system to convert number into binary. Here we are converting to binary, that's why your target base system is 2. That's why you are dividing with 2. If you divide this number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then what result you will get? See, 2 into 6 equals to 12, that's why 6 has come here. If you divide this number, okay, 2 into 1, 2, remainder 1, then 14, 7 comes here, then 2 into 2, 4. Now, remainder comes 1. See, it's a remainder, it's your quotient. Similarly, if you number divide this number, the quotient you will get this and remainder you will get 0. Again, you divide this number till the time you are not getting at 0 or 1 in the bottom, you will divide the number. When you get 1 or 0, that means you have to less than this number, okay? So, till the time you will divide that number, 1001, this number you are getting. And how you will write this? Always, when you writing this number into binary, you will go bottom to top, bottom to top, okay? Fine. See, I will show the, okay, wait, here, capture, here. Yes, see, we capture this thing here. So decimal to binary conversion. Decimal number is your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As I told you, the method you have to divide this with base, target base, and remainder will be written over here. This one is your LCB, and here the last digit will be your MCB. Okay. So how you will write? You will write from the bottom to top. That from in bottom you are getting 1. Here 1 is written 1, 1, then 0, 0, 0, 0. So when you write an answer, you have to write from top to bottom. Okay. Next is your decimal to octal conversion. Next is your decimal to octal conversion. Here you will see that decimal. What is your decimal number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The number we are taking, the same number we are taking. And here target base is changed because you have to convert this number into octal, and the base of octal is 8. So till the time you are not getting the number less than the base, you will divide the number here, then you will get this will be your remainder 1. Okay, if you divide this with 8 into 1 equals to 8, remainder is 4, 43. Number of times you will write, five number of times, then 40, then remainder will 3, 34, then 8 into 4 equals to 32, remainder will 2, then 25, 8 into 3 equals to 24, the remainder you will get 1. Similarly, you have to divide the whole thing, and till the time you will not get the number less than your base, you will divide. Okay, this is your remainder, this is your quotient, and when you writing an answer, you will write from bottom to top. Always remember, I'm saying again and again that you have to write answer from bottom to top. So answer is 30071. And don't forget write base over here. Okay, don't forget to write base over here. This shows that you convert of decimal number into octal number. Fine. Now next example we see, that is hexadecimal. Decimal to hexadecimal. Okay. This is the number. I'm zooming again. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what is your target base? Target base is 16, because you are converting from decimal to hexadecimal. Okay, so from 16 you will divide 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fine. Then you remainder will get 9. If you divide this number with 16, remainder will get remain 3. Then 43, remainder will 0, and at last you will get 3 here. Fine. So what will be your answer? Your answer will be 3039 and the base is 16. 3039 and the base is 16. Okay, 3039. Now again we are taking an example. We will convert this decimal number into hexadecimal. Okay, 7, 2, 5, then 45, then 2. So when you divide this number, you will get quotient, you will get 45, and remainder you will get 5. Again, when you divide this number, you will get remainder 2. Okay. Remainder 30, the remainder you will get 13, and at last you will get 2. So you will write 2, 13 and 5. And in 13, in place of 13, you will write D, because 10 is equals to A, 11 is equals to B, 12 is equals to C, 13 is equals to D, 14 is equals to E, and 15 is equals to 5, as I told you in the previous slides. Okay. So the answer is 2D5, top bottom to top. Fine. We learn the conversion decimal to other base system. Fine. Now if other base system we have to convert from other base system to decimal number system. So to convert from any other base system to decimal number system, you have to just follow these three steps. First one, determine the base value of a source number system that you want to convert, and also determine the position of digits from LSB. First digit position is 0, then second digit position is 1, and so on. Second step, multiply each digit with its corresponding multiplication of position value and base of source number system base. Add the resulted value in step B. Okay, see here one example we are giving you. Okay, explanation regarding examples. Below given examples contain the following rules. Rule 1, contain the digit of a number. Row 2, position of the digit. Then row 3, digit into base and power position. That is, power is position. Row 4 will contain step C, and then add each value of step D, resulted value in decimal number C. This is your row 1. As I told you, it contain the what? Your number. Wait. Yeah. See. Here is your number. Fine. You capture this and add to new page. Copy from here. Okay. You can say we can move it down. On our next page. Does it come here? No. number, your number, binary number is given 11000. That much times 0, then 1, 1, 1, and 0. This is your binary number. Fine. And here you are getting the positions of all the numbers. Fine. It's over, written over here. Your number is 110 and 1. One more one is missing over here. Okay. So, if we are converting this number to, see here, this is your binary to decimal conversion. How you will convert this? Now, your number is written over here 100101 and your base is binary. You have to convert this into decimal number. From here, you will write the position of all the numbers. Okay, so you will write here 0, then 1, you will write over here 1, position you have to mention, then 2, then 3, 4, okay, and at last 5. Fine. From this position you will start here. You will write 1 into multiple of 2 ki power 0. Power of 2 is 0 because here position of this number is 0. That's why we are taking 0. Now come to next number 0. 0 into 1 into 2 ki power 1 because position of 0 is 1. Next is 1 into 2 ki power 2. That's why you are written over here 1 into 2 ki power 2. Then 0 into 2 ki power 3. Again check 0 into 2 ki power 4 and 1 into 2 ki power 5. By writing these, add all these numbers. Add these of these numbers. As you know, if any number having a power of 0, that means the value of this number is 1. Okay, so 1 into 1 is 1. If any number we multiply any number with 0, we will get 0. Then 1 to the power 2 means 4. Okay, that's why 4 into 1, 4. 0 because number is 0 here, 0. And 2 to the power 5, 32. 32 into 2, 1 is 32. When you add the number, you will get answer this. Okay, and you will write this 37. With, don't forget to write the base. Okay, here you will get 37 into part 10. Fine. Yes, now hexadecimal number. We already done hexadecimal number, that what are hexadecimal number. But how you will convert hexadecimal number into decimal? We see the converted decimal to hexadecimal, but how you will convert hexadecimal to decimal? So number is written over here. 25 is your hexadecimal number and you have to convert it into decimal. So how will you convert? Same as you converted binary to decimal. Only change the base, where when we convert binary to decimal, there we use, instead of 16, we use 2 because the base of binary number is 2. But here we are converting hexadecimal to decimal, so we are using 16. From last number, the position of 5 is 0 and 25 is 1. So 16 is your base and power 0. 16 power 0. So 5 into 16 power 0. Fine. And here 2 into 16 power 1. Fine. It's, if any number having a power 0, as I told you, that its value is 1. So 5 into 1 is 5. And 2 into 16 is 32. When you add this number, you will get 37 as a result. 10. Write down the base over here, that it's 10. Okay, so that you can understand. Now, decimal to hexadecimal, I already told you. Okay, binary to hexadecimal. Wait, octal number slide is missing. We will see where is that. Okay, my bit will come later on. The same you have to do with octal also. If the same number is given over here with like 25 with the base of 25 with the base of 8, okay, then what will you do? Same 5 into 8 power 0 for octal, okay, for octal 8 into 0, and instead of 16 you will write 8. So the result what will come? 5 into 8 power 0, that will come 5 only, and 2 into 8, 16, the result will come 21 in the when you convert from octal to decimal. Okay, the same procedure you have to follow. These are the some example I am giving you. 4 bit, these are 4 bit group, decimal digit and hexadecimal. How you will see how this comes in place, it's always word. This is we call shortcut method also. 8 for second we will write 4, for this one we write 3, 2, then 1. Fine. If 0, for 0 if we need no number from these numbers, we need no number to for writing a 0. That's why all bits are 0. For 1, we need this 1. Okay, so instead of in the place of 1, we will write 1 else 0. For 2, we will write here in place of 2, we'll write 1 else 0. So come forward for 5s. Okay, we will see for 5 how. 5, the sum of 4 plus 1 is equals to 5. So in place of 4, we will write 1, and in place of 1, we will write 1. So 4 plus 1 is 5. That's why in place of 4, we are writing 1, and in place of 1, we are writing 1. Else, we will write 0. Similarly, you will do for all prior to your home. Okay, this method also. Now, next. Binary to hexadecimal. How you will convert any number, any binary number to hexadecimal number? Starting at the right end and split it into 4 groups. Okay. See, if we start, because it's hexadecimal, so we will start from here and we will split it into 4. Change the color. We will change the color. Yeah. Then again it 4. Now you will say, ma'am, it's only 1 is remaining. So leave it for the time being. So we make a group of 4 and leave. And before 1, write down 3 more zeros. Okay. We add 3 more zeros. Now it's again we make a group of 4. If we write down here 8, 4, 2, 1. Then what number it becomes? It becomes 6. 4 plus 2, 6. So answer is 6 written over here. Now if we do with this, then 8 plus 2, 10. And I already told you that 10 is equals in hexadecimal, 10 is equals to A. Fine. 10 is equals to A. So it's written A here. If we see this number 8, 4, 2, 1, in place of 1, 1 is written, so answer is 1. So this is your answer. And you will write from bottom to top. 1A6. 1A6. So binary, this is your binary, and what the answer is? 1. What the answer is 1A6 in hexadecimal. Now, hexadecimal to binary. If a number is written in hexadecimal and you have to convert that in binary, how you will convert? This is your number 3D and 9. When you convert it into binary with 8421, okay, write down 8421, 4213. For 3, we need 221. So it's a binary number of 3, it's a binary number of 3. What is D? D means 10 is A, yeah, 11 is B, and 12 is C, 13 is D. So for 13, 8, 4, and 1. This is, you can say, 13. Okay. Now, for 9, the conversion of binary is this. Fine. Now you will say, ma'am, binary number, its a base is 2. So, how we can say, we have to convert it into group of 3. Okay. Like this, we will write 1. From here, you will write down 1, y. From here, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, okay, then 1, 0, 0, leading zeros. You can remove leading zeros. Here, one, this one is written over here. It's by mistake, it's written as a subscription. So, 1 is here over here. Okay, and this shows your base only. Fine. So don't forget to write down 1 over here. If I'm mistaken, it's written in subscription. Now next, octal number system. I told you what are octal number system. Okay, these are the decimal number and these are the octal of these decimal numbers. We already done this. So how you will convert octal to? Now, we converted already decimal to octal. So similarly, if number is 357, how you will convert it into octal? Same. The first number will get the position of 5, 0. Position of, 7 is 0, 5 is 1, then 3 is 2. Okay. So 8 power 0 is 1, result will come 8 power 1, result will come 8, 80 power 2, result will come 64. So multiply these all numbers, 3 into 64, 5 into 8, and 7 into 1. 7 into 1 plus 5 into 8 plus 3 into 64. Okay, so this number, add this number and you will get 239 as a result. Fine. Next is your decimal to octal, we already did by dividing method. Now binary to octal, how? Because in octal we see 127 number. So what will be the grouping? Grouping will be 3, because 4, 2, 1. If you add these number, 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7. If you add these number, you will get what? You will get the result of 7. All number cover 7. So here we will make a group of 3, 3. This 1 group, 2 group, 3 group, 4th, 5th, 6th group. Okay. Now 4, 0, 1, 0, 1 is 4 plus 1, 5. Then whole 3 are 1, then 7. This you will get 4, this group you will get 0, for this 2, then 1. Now combine these all numbers, 1, 2, 0, 4, 7. Okay, so from binary to octal, and octal to binary is just a reverse of that. Fine. How you will add two binary numbers? The question come, how will you add? First see that the number should be, both are binary. Okay, 1 plus 0 is 1. am writing over here. Wait, yeah, where is the keyboard? Okay, see, 1 plus, okay, we will write from here. One plus zero is equals to is equals to one, then zero plus one is equals to one, zero plus zero is equals to 0, and 1 plus 1 is equals to 1, 0. Fine. Now we will add these numbers. When you add 1 plus 0, you will get simply 1. When you add 1, 1, you are getting result is 1, 0. So 0 you will write here and 1 as a carry over here. Okay. Carry. So 1, 0. When you add this 1, 0, you will get 1, 1, 0, then you will get 1. And here, you will get 1, 0. 1, 0 is 1. Okay, are you getting? So only you have to see if two 1s are coming, then there in place of this, you will write 1, 0. And then gives carry to next number. Fine? Next, so when you convert it again into decimal number, 8421, so 8 plus 4 is 12, then 1. Fine, so you will get as a resultant 30. Okay, next slide.